Look at all these beautiful people out here today. It's getting bigger! Who's here for liberty? This is awesome. Thank you for coming.
Thank you for coming.
I'll be here any day to fight for liberty. All right. Thank you all for being here. You are the powerful group of people that have helped us to push back this government tyranny. You are the microscopic minority that pushed for liberty. Look at the amazing results we have accomplished together. When I first got involved, I failed to understand how one person could make a difference. But now, I see it clearly. One person makes a difference by speaking the truth. When others hear the truth, they latch on and gain confidence to speak even more truth. Look at the results we are getting. Jason Kenney essentially repeated everything we have been saying here in the legislature on Monday. He is committed to dropping the provincial state of emergency by June 15th. All of their deadlines are being pushed earlier. We have made a tremendous impact together. Now is not the time for complacency. We must keep pushing. Deep down, every person here today recognizes the fact that there is an evil force at work that runs much deeper than our provincial politics. Amen. This evil has corrupted every level of our Canadian system.
You got that right.
Right from the municipal and country level through to the provincial level and beyond the federal level. Our universities and colleges have become cesspits of communist ideology. Our churches have been rendered useless. Our friends and family have been brainwashed. This is where the real fight lies. This lockdown has only served to open the eyes of the people to the tyranny that is being unleashed on the world at large. Jason Kenney has been an easy target, and we hit him hard. In just a few short weeks, he has a completely new tune. But Jason Kenney is just a minor player. Why did all of the developed world act in lockstep? Why did the entire world destroy their own economies and with it any chance of a prosperous future for their children? This has never been about a pandemic. This has been entirely about the destruction of nations and liberty as we know it.
You got that right!
Yeah!
Yeah.
This agenda to destroy nations and adopt the new world order has been around since biblical times. It is purely the work of Satan himself. Dr. Henshaw and Mr. Kenney were not crafting these policies of destruction. They were following orders. They have sold their souls to the new world order.
They are puppets.
Even our mayors that have been, sorry.
I've sinned.
Get kind of wrinkly
no,
on the mark.
Just make it up, they don't know.
No balls, I've sinned.
Even our mayors have sold their souls and with it your children's futures. Look at all the insane policies that have been acted from every level of government in recent times. All the major cities across Canada have adopted Vision Zero, a plan from Sweden, created. Oh my goodness, I'm falling apart today. On the surface, it sounds positive. The goal is reducing traffic deaths. The reality is that it will eventually make commuting from the suburbs impossible. Already, cities across Canada are acting in lockstep and reducing residential speed limits to 30 kilometers per hour. Vision Zero is the reason you can no longer turn left on a green light at most intersections. Sure, saving lives sounds good. We've been hearing a lot about saving lives. But you must understand how these simple policies interact with other policies. Why would they want to make your commute longer? Agenda 21 and Agenda 2030 are the reason they want your commute to be longer. Agenda 21 and 2030 are the reason we hear all our government puppets talking about sustainable development. It sounds nice, doesn't it?
No.
Well, it isn't. It's pure tyranny. Under Agenda 21 and 2030, which your government signed on to, people will be forced to live in urban areas, but not the suburbs. Owning a house will be unattainable under this new normal. You are expected to live in 200 square foot micro apartments. You will not own a car. Your work will most likely be within walking distance of your micro apartment. This sounds more like a Foxconn factory than the country I grew up in. Will we need suicide nets as well? These agendas speak of eliminating world hunger and poverty, which is a noble goal. But if you read it closely, it isn't so much about raising living standards for the poor, it is more about lowering the living standards for the middle class in developed nations. These agendas are designed to reduce your consumption. Everything you do will be tracked and monitored. How much water you are allowed to use, the banning of air conditioning, the banning of private vehicles. This isn't about raising living standards in the third world, it is about bringing down living standards in the first world. They are literally planning to send us all into ghettos.
Hello.
Move them! I do not consent!
Me neither!
I do not consent!
You're not alone!
Why else would Clearwater County amend their bylaws to prevent hobby farms from selling their produce? Only factory farms will be tolerated in the new normal. Humanity has been declared a virus on nature. You will not be permitted in the wilderness. You will not own an acreage. This is the formation of the Hunger Games in real life. The New World State wants to control every aspect of our lives. They will regulate the internet, and you and I will no longer be allowed to speak freely.
That's
you
bullshit.
Already see this happening. If you want a preview
bullshit.
Of what is to come, look no further than to China. Look at how the whole world has adopted the Chinese Communist Party policy as the response to this pandemic, without question. China is the model for this new world order, and your leaders at every level of government have signed over liberty into the hands of the devil himself. This tyranny knows no bounds. They will not stop unless we stop them. I want you to contemplate how far gone this nation already is. We have elected a prime minister that admitted on camera that he admires China's basic dictatorship. We have elected a prime minister that has said that Christians are the worst part of our society.
Maybe they should go live in China.
We have elected a prime minister that insists because of our low birth rate, we must bring in over 300,000 immigrants each year, as well as throwing the doors wide open to illegal refugee claims, while simultaneously pushing for the murdering of our unborn children. This is satanic. Those of you out here that have studied the Bible know exactly where this is headed.
You got that right.
But I believe that the dates are not set in stone. We can fight back this satanic agenda. We can take back this nation. We can be free. This fight is just getting started. We must awaken our friends and neighbors to the tyranny that has engulfed our nation. We must confront the brainwashing at every possible opportunity. We must take back our institutions and churches. These radical professors that push all this garbage down our throats on a daily basis need to be fired. The radicals that have taken over the teachers' unions need to be fired. The radical school board trustees like Bridget Sterling, who has no children and has no experience teaching in public schools, need to be fired. We must infiltrate all of these corrupted institutions and take back our rightful authority as the shareholders in this country we call Canada. We need good people to stand up. We need good people to get involved and take back these positions of authority. We need to be ready to tackle these issues head on. We need to discuss politics at the dinner table. Our very lives depend on it. Canadians are known for their politeness, but this politeness will be the death of our nation if we do not stand up now. So speak the truth. Confront the liars. We are mad as hell, and we're not going to take this anymore.
And no more political correctness.
I assure you the things that I have brought up today are merely the tip of the iceberg. If you start investigating these things for yourself by reading the United Nations own publications and the publications put forth from our own government, you will begin to understand how much trouble we are really in. I will not be tagged like cattle. I will not be herded like cattle. I will not be controlled like cattle because I am not cattle. We are people. We demand our liberty. We demand our rights. We demand our country back. We will take this country back. We will get involved. We will tackle this together. We will not tolerate tyranny. We will not tolerate corruption. And we will not tolerate lies and deception. Together, we can change the future. Together, we can give our children true liberty. Together, we can fight back this evil agenda and improve the lives of the entire globe. We will not stop. We will not rest. We will overcome this fight until our last breath if necessary. But we will overcome this tyranny together. The question to these leaders I have is, who do you serve? Who are your masters? We need good people to take ownership and responsibility of this country. And those people stand before me today. Let's take this country back!